So, for your lesson today, you need your plan from yesterday. So yesterday, you rewrote the conversation between the warden, Mr. Sir, and Stanley. And your plan should look something like this, but hopefully a lot longer than my one, because my one was just an example. And today, you're going to be writing up this plan into an actual piece of dialogue that you might see in a book. So what I've done, just to start me off, is I've done a sentence just describing what's happening before I go into the dialogue. So that's something that you might want to do as well. So I've got, as Stanley gingerly followed Mr. Sir into the air-conditioned cabin, an irritated warden slammed down the book she was flicking through. And you can see, I had this on my plan, that she was reading a book as they walked in. So now I'm going to include her piece of dialogue. So remember, when we're writing dialogue, we need a new paragraph that's indented for each new speaker. So we've got our inverted commas, we've got our capital to start speech. So I'm going to say, why are you bothering me? Now this is a question, so obviously we need our question mark inside our inverted commas. And then we've got to put our reporting clause. On my plan, my idea was snapped. And I'm going to use that, but I might add a little bit extra in. I might say, snapped the warden impatiently. So on my plan, I have done that first bit. Now I'm going to move on to Mr. Sir. This time, instead of having the reporting clause at the end of the sentence, I'm going to have it at the beginning. So, it's a new speaker, so a new paragraph. So I'm going to say, Mr. Sir pointed to Stanley. Oh, I might put a little relative clause in here actually. Who stood awkwardly in the doorway, comma, and protested. Now, all of this is a reporting clause. It's telling us who is speaking, and it's coming before the speech. So Mr. Sir is about to speak. We know what he says. So we need a comma. We need our inverted commas. And he says, this little outlaw is lying about my seeds. Full stop, close the inverted commas. Okay, now I have got a reporting clause at the end of speech, a reporting clause at the beginning of speech, and a relative clause here. Now I'm going to do a reporting clause in the middle of speech. Okay, and this is a tricky one, but I want you to try it. So, Stanley is going to speak now. And he's going to say, with certainty, I did steal them, ma'am. So, new paragraph for Stanley. He's going to start speaking. And I'm changing my plan a little bit. But, ma'am, Stanley interrupted. Oh, can I fit it in? No. Interrupted. Now, he said,
But ma'am, I did steal them. And this is what we call the reporting clause in the middle. Okay, now he's continuing his sentence. And because he's continuing what he was saying before, think about whether we need to use a capital or not, because it's still part of this sentence. And we don't have to here. But ma'am, Sally interrupted, I did steal the seeds. Full stop, close inverted commas. Okay, so there is your reporting clause in the middle. Your steps to success say to vary the position. So try to have some reporting clauses at the end, some at the beginning of the speech, and some in the middle. Although this one can be a bit tricky. Okay. But the most important part is punctuating it accurately. We're all really good with using our inverted commas to show the words that actually come out of the characters' mouths. But sometimes we do forget our capitals at the beginning, and sometimes we forget our punctuation at the end. Okay, if you're introducing speech, you need a comma before they start to speak, if your reporting clause is at the beginning. And if you're breaking up the speech with a reporting clause, you need to use commas as well. Okay, so really do check the missing commas. Okay, so hopefully that's all very clear for you. You can see, look, my half painted nails, half from being the warden, half from just being Miss David. Okay, right. Right.